Hello everyone, in this video I'm gonna show you what we're gonna create over the course of this tutorial series. As you can probably guess from the name of the project, we're gonna create Bomberdude, which is a Bomberman clone, and if you don't know what Bomberman is, then let me just show you what the gameplay is like. As we can hear, there is a nice music playing in the background, which will continue to play even if we transition to the game scene. So let me just press the start button to transition to the game scene. Since the music is loud, let me just take it a bit down so you can hear me clearly. On the top left corner of the screen, you can see a timer counting down from 200. And when this timer reaches 0, then the speed of all the enemies in the level will increase, making it much more difficult to complete the level. You can also walk using WASD keys, and you will play a walking sound effects when doing so. Also, you can place bombs using spacebar, which also plays a bomb placing sound effect. You can only destroy these crates and not these gray walls. Each enemy you kill adds 100 points to your score, and your score is at the top right corner of the screen. Now currently my score is 0, and I'll have to kill an enemy to increase the score. So let me just kill one. They also play a nice animation when they die. Okay, so I have implemented two pickups in the game. So one pickup is underneath this crate. Now this pickup increases the maximum bomb capacity of the player, which means you can now place two bombs simultaneously. And this pickup increases the explosion radius of the bomb. So now, previously, I could only damage up to one cell around the bomb. Now I can damage up to two cells around the bomb, as you can see. Now to go to the next level, I have to find the door. It is also hidden among these crates. I have to each crate to find it. And before going to the other level, I have to kill all the enemies. So let me just take a quick shortcut. Now we only have one enemy, and I'm going to show you what happens when the timer reaches 0. Now, unlike the original game, if I explode a bomb next to the door, it won't spawn more enemies. So that's different in this game. And also the camera won't move. Camera is fixed. And now if you see, timer has reached 0, and when this enemy start moving, it will be much faster. Now it is difficult to. Now I can go to the next level. Okay. Now, as you can see, the data from previous level is persistent in this thing, in this game. So the player data is persistent. As you can see, I can place two bombs, and those bombs also do damage up to two cells. And I want to show you one other thing. Now when the player dies, the player will also play its death animation, which is quite similar to enemy, and the scene will transition to you lose scene, and it will play you lose sound effect. So in the next video, we're going to download Unity and set up our project. So I'll see you in the next video.